Hi Aries, welcome back to Omkara Tarot. It's time for yet another love bite. Aries, this is just going to be a small energy check-in to see how you guys are doing in your life, in your love life, see what you need to know and what advice we have from the universe to deal with that. So let's begin. Dear God, Goddesses, Angels, Spirit Guides, please bless this reading for Aries and send them the messages they need to hear the most at this time. Thank you. So Aries, as usual, we'll be taking an Angel Blessing card to top the reading. Let's see what my angels have for you for the weekend. Blessing or an advice for my Aries gangs, my angels. Blessing or an advice card for my Aries. Okay, this one. Thank you. Let's put the rest back. So, the card we have for you, Aries, is peaceful. Great. So, how are we going to find peace this weekend, Aries? Let's see. Welcome back, all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your support to the channel. I'm very, very blessed to have you all here today with me. I'm eternally grateful. Thank you. And if you're new here, we welcome you to our Omkara family to join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. This, of course, is just a mini read for, I'm recording this for the weekend. These are your energies. Doesn't mean this is going to happen this weekend. It can, but this is how your energy is flowing this weekend, what you guys are going through. So let's see what's in store, Aries. And if you guys need a personal reading, my email is in the description box below. You can always reach me there, Aries. Ace of Pentacles, bottom of my deck. Wow. Okay, so one of my subscribers reached out and said, how about we take three extra cards of advice at the end? So let's take those as well. So three cards of advice, Spirit. We'll open these later. Okay. So the first card I have for you here, Aries, is the Hanged Man. In reverse, which is nice, the Sun and the Eight of Pentacles. Oh. We don't want somebody returning back, do we? Death in reverse, Six of Wands in reverse, and the Four of Wands in reverse. We don't want a cross watcher's reading here, Spirit. Somebody wants to come out of their stuck place. Aries, you are seen as, this could be you, this could be a cross watcher, but from what I feel, there is somebody who sees you as the bright shining light of their life. And I see somebody here wanting to return to bask in the sunshine, it seems. There is a fear of change. Somebody doesn't want things to end. They don't want things to end from, you know, they don't want it to break up maybe, or they don't want things to kind of completely shut down between the two of you. Somebody is feeling rather embarrassed and ashamed to face you. They feel their happily ever after is in jeopardy here, but they are very embarrassed and shy and feeling, not knowing how to come towards you, Aries. You're scaring somebody off, it seems. Even though this person, I think, wants to send you this message, right? They don't know what to do here. Okay, so somebody also commented in my last video, said same boring shit. And yes, it is. But I can only read the cards as they come, right? I wish this was a soap opera and I could write a script for you every other day, Aries. But if you don't change and your person doesn't change, your cards don't change, right? Somebody's stuck on you, I can't help it. This person is stuck to your energy. They want to come out of this. They are enlightened now. They know now, oh my God, this sunshine is what I want. I want to return to it. So let's see, Hangman, Spirit. Hangman. They're bored, feeling rejected, feeling lonely, feeling all is lost. Sad character. But now, while they've been sitting in their isolation, they are now getting enlightened. They are like the Buddha who's been sitting under a tree and getting epiphanies that, and now this person is conflicted. And they're also now thinking of all the conflicts maybe they've created between the two of you. One more. For the hanged man. What can I say, Aries? Now this person wants to come back and romance you, and they feel that they are also a bit rejected and dejected because they are fearing that you may have other people now vying for your attention. They feel that now it may be a bit too late because now they'll have to compete. This is one person, these are five, right? All vying for attention for Aries and saying, me first, me first, me first. They know that Aries is highly in demand and maybe has many, many suitors now. So that's the reason I think they're a bit scared and they're feeling a little afraid to come forward. They are not sure whether you are still available to them. So they are trying to get enlightened. So what's the Sun card for then, Spirit? Why is the Sun card here? They are not happy without you, Aries. I think they've also kind of understood that you are now not, you're shining too bright. You are not looking, you're not chasing after them for a reunion. And I think they are also realizing that you've taken off for a fresh new beginning for yourself. And you're looking very happy, you're looking very chuffed with life, and you're glowing. And this person is now wondering what to do. How do I return? Eight of Cups. Yes, here this person is. They feel that whatever they've done to you, instead of, you know, they were trying to maybe kind of put you down or play games with you, they feel that every game they played with you has backfired and now they are the loser. Now they're looking back in regret and sorrow and upset and wondering how now do I rectify this stupid mistake that I've made where I was trying to play games with Aries and now Aries is winning and I'm losing, right? So how do I make this come back now? Yes, trigger warning, Aries. You can switch off right now. I mean, it's the same reading. I'm sorry. One more. Eight of Cups. Deeply unhappy. Somebody is deeply, deeply, deeply unhappy. They are not happy at all as the way things have happened. They are seeing you shining, they are sitting sad, they feel you have lots of competition, lots of suitors, new love maybe in your life. They don't know how they're going to fight for your attention again now, Aries. But they are so scared because they don't want to lose you. Okay, death in reverse, they're holding on tight. They don't know with what face to come to you anymore. Right? Embarrassed, ashamed at whatever they've done, feeling that they can never have their happily ever after or their stability ever again. Yeah, this is in reverse, sorry. So death spirit, what's this death card? This person is at crossroads right now. They're still planning, thinking, what do I do? What do I do? How do I turn this around now? How do I transform this energy now? They feel this is their bad karma that they are now getting. Whatever they've done, they've been dealt the hand of God, I think, now. They're paying for whatever mischief they've done. They see you happy and they see their life stuck. This is what they feel karma has done for them, right? They see Aries happy and they see their life has come at hold. Nothing is moving in their life. And they feel this is karmic justice for what they have done in the past, right? So, Six of Wands, Spirit. Why is the Six of Wands here? Six of Wands. This person is realizing that even though they are keeping a watch on you, they want to take action towards you. See, they are looking at you. They are watching you. They are looking at you. They are very passionate towards you. They want to take action towards you. But right now, they have no face. They don't know how they can face. They're embarrassed to face you right now. This is like a huge tower moment that this person is going through, Aries. This is a cross watcher's read. So, yeah, this person is going through a big tower moment. Of course, this could be Aries you, right? This could be you who's done this to somebody else. I don't know. But from the comments that I've heard, I think this is your cross watcher, because the story is an ongoing story, I think, for a few months now. So what's this tower moment, Spirit, that this person is going through? What's this tower moment this person is going through? I think they want to take some action, Aries, and they want to do it like swiftly, like, you know, ripping a band-aid off kind of a thing. They feel the only way I can do it is if I surprise or shock my Aries with something really fast moving and maybe try and see if I can heal something in this relationship. Right now, they're not happy. They feel that they've lost you. With the Four of Wands in reverse, they are quite convinced that things have already been over, and what is the worst that can happen? So they're planning to do something maybe shocking or surprising, or suddenly try their one last attempt to bring some justice back into this equation. Because right now they feel all is lost. Their Ten of Pentacles is gone, their Four of Wands is gone, and the only way to bring justice back would be something silly as this, Spirit. Can I have one more? What are they planning? They want to come back and get you emotional. This is what's on their mind. They want to come and tell you that, you know, do you remember when we met? Remember that ice cream? Remember that chocolate? Remember that trip we took? Remember this? That they are thinking that I'll suddenly go and, you know, kind of remind Aries of all the loving memories that we've shared in the past, get them a little sentimental, okay? And then, yeah, it'll all get fine, it'll all get balanced out. Aries is going to forgive me, hearts will be healed, and maybe then I have a chance. Wow. Let's see here. Ace of Cups, Five of Swords, and the Four of Swords. What's this Ace of Cups coming for Aries, Spirit? Aries, I don't think you're allowing it. You feel the love maybe, or you think there could be love here, but right now, Aries, you know that this is not a balanced relationship. I don't think you're going to be allowing it, at least not yet. You are still going to have some questions about this Five of Swords behavior which has been done in the past. You are not going to allow them to shut that chapter off or roll things under the rug and say, hey, we're not going to talk about it. You're not offering your love, Aries, to or allowing them to kind of just, you know, pretend it never happened. The world in reverse. They don't want to shut that old chapter or discuss it to start something new. They just want a continuation, which, Aries, I don't think you're allowing. You, I think, are going to remind them or remember this trickster behavior and this mind games that the person played with you or hurt you. Four of Swords in reverse. Four of Swords in reverse. Yes, I think, Aries, I think you are turning your back on them. You're turning your back on them. You're not going to allow anyone who's not going to give you clear communication. You have to put the past to rest before you can start something new, is what you're going to be saying here, Aries. You don't want to get stressed again. You will be turning your back on this person. If this person is going to be wishy-washy or, you know, kind of confuse you any longer, you're not going to be allowing it at all. Okay? So with no communication, no decision. Aries takes their power back and is no longer giving of their love. So let's see what the universe has for you. Ace of Pentacles, wow, and the Eight of Swords and the Strength card. So what's this Ace of Pentacles spirit for Aries? Ace of Pentacles. And the Eight of Swords. And the Strength card. One more. Yes, Aries, I think you're very clear. You are not going to allow any kind of transformation right now. Somebody, yes, does want to have a brand new beginning here. But you are not going to be allowing them. You are still very stressed about this unequal partnership or unequal give and take that happened in the past. This foundation which was rocked, I think. This person's rude, mean behavior from the past. You are going to hold back. You are not going to be investing yet till this person can reveal all their secrets, right? You will only make a decision regarding this Four of Wands after they come clean. And they know that, and that's why they're stressing out. So Aries, you're in a very peaceful space. You are just going to be sitting, leaning back and enjoying the show. Well, this person scrambles, I think, to move things along. But I don't think, Aries, you're going to bite it. Not so soon. All right, so that's all I have for you. Stay in your peaceful zone, Aries, and don't let anyone ruffle your feathers, okay? Love and light. Take care. Namaste.